seems to be beneficial, so that's good. And on the days when you can't get here because it's fully booked, you've still got to go online, so that's a good thing too. Relaxing down over the legs as much as you're able.
Make sure that your hips stay down on the floor. Don't let them lift up. Great. And now from here, let's just gently walk the hands over toward the right side. Just moving nice and slow and making sure that that left hip stays down on the floor. So one of your body's protective reflexes will be to contract the muscles of the side body and lift that hip up as you move. And we want to counter that reflex slowly with mindfulness so that we can increase our flexibility. Again, as you inhale, think of expanding the back and the side body. As you exhale, notice where you can relax, maybe through the jaw, maybe through the shoulders. Great, and now walk the hands back toward the body so the shoulders are more stable, and down again through neutral and over toward the left side. And then we're just going to relax down over that left leg. So we're not forcing anything. We start up nice and high to make sure the lower back stays nice and safe. And then we just relax down over that leg, looking for that stretch in the right lower side body mostly. You might also feel it in the ribs and the shoulders. Check that your shoulders are always down, away from the ears as far as they'll go. Breathe into the stretch, expanding the ribcage as you inhale, and relaxing down as you exhale. Great, and now we'll walk the hands back toward the body and come back to center once again, and relax right down the middle. Relax the arms and neck, and again, if your lower joints are starting to hurt you here, you can straighten the legs at any time for a staff or forward fold. Right. And now let's walk the hands back up, and we're going to bring the fingertips to the floor behind us. So I'd like you to find your straight spine as much as you can to begin. We're always sucking the belly button toward the spine. So there's two ways to contract the abdominal muscles. You can squeeze the core and push them out, or you can squeeze the core and suck them in. And we always want to be doing the sucking in. That's going to prevent things like hernias, for one thing, and also keep that nice form in our lower, in our center of the body. So shoulders are down and back, and we're looking for the stretch to the front of the shoulders and through the shoulder blades, the back of the body. Take a deep breath in here, staying up on the fingertips, and we'll exhale and just drop the head back. Just relax the neck for now. Check and make sure that the shoulders do not climb up toward the ears. Breathe and feel everything from the chin down to the shoulders and collarbone open up. Good. One more deep breath in. Exhale, and we'll bring the hands forward and relax down over the legs to release the neck. You can bring the chin toward the chest if you'd like. And if you'd like to try another modification, you can press the hands into the floor, pushing them down and out to round the middle back as you tuck the tailbone and chin. And that will bring that stretch into the middle lats and intercostal muscles through the center of the rib cage. Good. And then we'll walk the hands back up, and we're going to bring the fingertips to the floor behind us once again. You might want to stay up onto the fingertips if that's more comfortable for your spine. Otherwise, you're going to take a deep breath in and extend the spine with me. And then exhale and come down onto the palms. Just notice how that feels for you. Put a little bit of weight on those hands, almost as though you could lift the hips up off the floor. Straighten the arm first, try and touch the ceiling. And then we'll exhale and bend the right elbow in toward the spine. Make sure you're nice and even across both hips on the floor. And if this is not okay for your neck and shoulder, you can release that arm down in front or bring the hand to the hip or behind the back. Good. Just remember, it's all yours. Modify however you need to. Good. And we're looking to get that bottom shoulder down as far as we'll go and feel that stretch through the left rib cage and side body, no matter where that left hand is resting. Good. Now let's inhale and come on up. Reach for the sky. Straighten the bottom arm. Exhale the left hand to the floor behind you, and we reset in the middle, opening up the shoulders, lengthening the spine, and now we'll come to the other side. Reach the right arm up toward the sky, breathe in deep. Exhale, bend the left elbow in toward the body. So we do that to keep our shoulders safe. If we bend the elbow out, we're going to compress the wrist and the shoulder, and there's higher potential for injury and not as much strength. Here, you can also push the hand into the floor to deepen the stretch, extending that right rib cage out even further. Remember that your top hand can come down anytime if your neck or shoulder feels too much strain or any pain at all. Good. Breathe into the fingertips. Breathe into the stretch. Mm-hmm. Now let's inhale and come up. Exhale, release that hand back to set. And legs. Now let's press up, and we'll sit up tall and straighten the legs out in front. So now we're in staff pose. We're flexing the feet back toward the body and pressing the backs of the knees into the floor. So first, we always set up into our asana, the beginning of our pose, and our neck is nice and long, and the shoulders are always down and back, core is contracted, and we're looking for a straight spine. If you're not able to maintain a straight posture in this pose, you can always bring the fingertips to the floor for a little extra support. So we're training perfect posture into the body here. Take a deep breath in. Exhale, tip from the hip, and just slowly walk the hands forward on either side of the legs. Now, as you come down over the legs, make sure that you're still pressing the backs of the knees down into the floor. I'd like you to flex the feet back toward the body to get the most length in those hamstrings. And think about leading with the center of your chest. So we have a tendency to come forward and we lead with the nose or with the shoulders, feeling like we're getting deeper into the stretch. But what we want is to come forward through the center of the body, because if the spine stays straight, then that's going to give us that better extension through the backs of the legs. So check those shoulders, roll them down and back as far as they'll go, and open up from the center of the chest. Now let's walk the hands back up, and we'll bring the right foot to the inside of the left calf or thigh, wherever is comfortable for you. Good, sit up tall, square the shoulders toward the extended leg, left foot points toward the sky and flexes back toward you. Take a deep breath in, core is strong, we sit up tall first, and then we exhale and tip from the hip. Slowly walking the hands forward on either side of that leg. Now, if you feel too much of a twist in your lower back, you can send in the shoulders between the knees if that's better for you. And of course, you're going to want to stay up higher if you feel too much tension in that right knee. You can straighten out both legs anytime if the twist is too much for your lower joints. And if you'd like to deepen the stretch in the right side body of your cage, crawl the right fingertips forward toward the instep of the left foot. Again, breathing into that stretch. And with every exhalation, notice where you can relax. Notice that the shoulders can move down and back a little further. Yeah, really good. Now let's walk the hands back up. Sitting up nice and tall. Then we'll bring the left hand to the right knee. So opposite hand to the bent knee. Inhale, right arm up toward the sky. Lengthen through the fingertips. Firm the core and sit up tall first. And then we bend, dropping the left shoulder down toward the left thigh. Excellent, yes. Now remember, your depth of stretch, your modification is always up to you. So your top hand can come down to the hip or behind the back anytime. You can come up straighter if you need to. You can even extend both legs for staff if your lower joints are uncomfortable. And again, we're looking for the stretch in that right rib cage. I'd like you to think about bending from the belly button to the crown of the head and keeping your lower back straight and strong with the power of the core. Bring it into the rib cage and side body. Yeah, that looks great, guys. Breathe. Look toward the sky if it's okay for your neck and shoulders, otherwise look toward the floor. Now let's inhale and come up. Exhale, release the hands back behind you. We're going to rock back and cross the right leg over the left. We're leaning back onto the hands for now until we know how the lower body feels about this, and then we'll sit up tall and grasp underneath the knee. Your option is to return and remove the twist or drop that knee back up to the side anytime. So now again, here we are with our postural correction. So holding just below the knee, I'd like you to roll the shoulders up, back, and down as far as they'll go. Feel the muscle contraction in the middle and the lower back. There's no contraction or tension in the shoulders and the neck. Tuck your elbows in and feel the triceps and biceps working here too. Good, so again, we're training in perfect posture so we can do it without having to think about it later on. Now when you're ready, if you'd like to take it a step further, you can wrap the left hand or arm around the right knee, so opposite arm to knee. We're prioritizing a straight spine, and then we'll look out over the back shoulder. Good, so in this stretch, just make sure that you're not allowing the shoulders or the chest to cave in toward that knee. Good, that looks great. Yep, and we're looking for the stretch through the spine, through the ribcage, also through that right knee, so through that right hip. Good, yes. Think of arching your lower back just a little bit and you'll deepen the stretch of the lower body. If you'd like to intensify, you can bring that right hand down to the floor at the base of the spine, or you can reach out and line the shoulder, or you can wrap that arm all the way around behind the back and brace it on the opposite hip. So just making it yours. Always making sure you can breathe deeply into that stretch, whichever modification you're using. One more deep breath in. Exhale, look forward, square the shoulders forward, and we'll release the leg. Straighten out both legs. Sit up tall, reset in staff pose, core strong, deep breath in. Exhale, tip from the hip, relaxing down over the legs. Good. And now walk the hands back up and bring the left foot to the inside of the right calf or thigh. So remember, this is a twist for our knee. If you're not comfortable with this, you can always remove the twist altogether, or the knee from the ceiling if you'd like. Now we're sitting up tall, taking a deep breath in. Exhale and tipping from the hip. Excellent. Relax down over that leg. And just notice how different this stretch is from the full stack. We should really feel that with that left lower side body especially. Good. And think about lengthening up and forward through the center of the chest, through your collarbone and solar plexus. Good. As you inhale, think of expanding the back. Breathe deeply into any muscles you feel stretching. And as you exhale, just relax a little deeper into the pose. If you'd like, you can crawl the left fingertips forward toward the instep of the right foot to deepen the stretch on that side of the body. Good. And always just checking in with our joints, with that left knee, with the lower back, neck and shoulders. Great. Now let's walk the hands back up and we'll sit up nice and tall, bringing the right hand to the left knee. Inhale the left arm up toward the sky. Sit up straight and tall first. Reach those fingertips toward the ceiling. And then we'll exhale and drop the right shoulder down toward the thigh. So again, think of squeezing your belly button toward the spine to straighten the lower back. And then bending from the belly button to the crown of the head. If you choose to reach up above, we're getting that arm as close as we can to the ear. Otherwise, that top hand can come to the hip or behind the back. Lengthen the neck. Lift the chest. Breathe deeply into the stretch. And remember, if you feel like you're trying too hard, you are. So no pain, no gain does not apply to yoga. You guys know that. So we're just easing into the stretch. And it should feel like a relief when we get to the depth of our stretch. Never pain. Now let's inhale and come up. Exhale, release the hands back behind you. We'll rock back and cross the left leg over the right thigh. So again, prioritizing straight spine and well-placed shoulders. And then we'll sit up tall and grasp just underneath that knee with both hands. And then here we have the elbows squeezing in toward the body, lengthening the neck, tucking the chin, and feeling the muscles of the back engage without us having to work too hard. Good, just breathe into that for a moment. And now we'll come into our twist. The right hand or the right arm wraps around the left knee. And we're straightening the spine first, and then bringing that twist from the crown of the head down to the belly button. Make sure both your hips stay down on the floor. You can arch your lower back if you'd like more. And you can also bring those left fingertips to the base of the spine, or reach out in line with the shoulder if you want to. Just make sure that whatever you're doing, you're able to maintain that upright posture. Breathe into the stretch, and whenever we're twisting, we're squeezing toxins out of the internal organs and helping with our circulation. So as you breathe, imagine massaging your internal organs with the breathing. And as you exhale, imagine breathing out all of those toxins that build up inside our systems. One more deep breath in. Exhale, look forward, square the shoulders forward, and we'll release the leg. Sitting up tall, shoulders down and back. Now, this time you can come into the staff or forward fold that we've done, or you can come into a seated yoga mudra with me, bringing the hands behind you. You can clasp the hands, or you can grasp the wrists or forearms, whatever's comfortable for you. And then we're going to sit up straight and tall, take a deep breath in. Exhale and press everything down toward the floor. Good. Down, 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 down. Good. You can bring the fingertips or the palms to the floor if that's what's best for you. And I'd like you to try and find the stretch through the fronts of the shoulders and the biceps. You can stay here or come with me and inhale the arms up and away from the body and then exhale and tip forward. Make sure the knees don't pop up and of course you can return to the forward fold that we did earlier in class with no upper body engagement anytime. Breathe deeply. Relax wherever you're able. And now let's look forward to come up with a straight spine. Bend the elbows to release the arms gently. Reach in front and curve around the upper back. Good, and now release and roll over into child's pose, sitting back into the heels. Here you can reach the arms out in front or bring them back by your sides or around. Now, child's pose is great. It's a true resting pose. So it's great for managing our stress levels, helping us sleep at night, even helping us feel more rejuvenated because it's a mild inversion. You can lower the head below the heart line here. Good. And we're breathing deeply into the back as we inhale. And as we exhale, noticing where you can relax. Now, from here, I invite you to come into the wide legged child's pose with me or the frog pose. So you can turn to the side in your mat so that your knees remain on the mat when you widen them if you like. Your elbows are going to come right underneath your shoulders for the best support. Let's part the knees, and you can bring the toes together if you're concerned about your knee flexibility and twisting, or you can bring the toes apart and the heels together for the full frog pose. From here, with most of our body weight resting on our elbows, we're just going to use that control to gently shift into the heels. So gently pressing the body back into the heels and feeling that stretch high up on the insides of the thighs. These are really important, very small muscles. So they take a lot of working. And that means that sometimes they tear, they take a long time to repair. If you've ever had a groin pull, you know what that's like. So I do highly recommend this kind of stretch at least a couple of times a week. Good, and now from here, if you'd like, you can gently walk the hands over toward the right side and notice how that changes your stretch, just bringing the focus. You can, remember, you can come back into child's pose anytime. This is a very deep hip opener. And then we'll just gently walk over toward the other side. And this is painful in any way. We just come up higher with the body and shift the body forward further to relieve the tension on the hips. Good, just breathing into it. Relax wherever you're able. You'll feel that the muscles are tensing around those joints, which is good. That's our protective reflex, but we have to focus to counter that if we want to gain flexibility. Just make sure you're doing it safely. And we'll come back to center. Bring the elbows under the shoulders. Bring the knees together to reset the hips and sit back into child's pose. Good. Really good. Now let's shift into table pose. Curl the toes under and lift up into downward dog. Gently press the heels toward the floor one at a time, or roll around with the balls of the feet. Spread the fingers and press the hands into the mat. And remember that you can bring the knees to the floor or the elbows to the floor at any time. Good. Relax wherever you're able. If your shoulders feel safe, you can move the body more toward the legs as you exhale to bring the stretch into the middle and upper back. One more deep breath in. Exhale, knees to floor, sit back, child's pose. And again, arm placement is completely up to you. You can rest the forehead on the fists or on the forearms. You can reach the arms out of the front or back by your sides. Good, and now we're going to shift forward onto the elbows to come into dolphin pose. If this is not a comfortable modification for you, come back to downward dog anytime. So now here, you can bring the palms together if you're concerned about your shoulder stability, or you can come with me and place the palms on the floor with the wrist, elbow, and shoulder all lined up on a straight plane. Inhale and curl the toes under. Exhale, and we're going to slowly lift the hips up toward the sky, really noticing how this feels for our shoulders as we move. Keep your shoulders down and back away from the ears. And I'd like you to just notice how the stretch is very different from our standard downward dog. You can come back to downward dog anytime. You can come to child's pose anytime. We're giving priority to our shoulder joint here, and we can round that. Great. One more deep breath in. Exhale, knees to floor, sit back, child's pose. Excellent. Just relax down. Do whatever you need to do. You can work out kinks anytime. Great. And then we'll shift into table pose. Curl the toes under and lift the hips up toward the sky. And we'll step into our runner stretch series. So let's bring the right foot forward between the hands, place the back knee down on the floor, and we'll bring our elbows to that front thigh and press the hips down toward the mat. Good. So now I ask you to bring the elbows to the thigh because this brings our upper body to a neutral angle, same angle as our mat leg, and that means that we're not hyperextending the lower back. We don't have to think about it right now. Now, if you like, you can curl the back toe under and lift the back knee up off the floor. I'd like you to tuck the tailbone. Let's see if you really target that stretch and then flex it. Yeah, good. Nice deep breathing. You can also press into the back heel to deepen the stretch of the calf and Achilles tendon. So just look for it wherever you need it today. Allow your hips to relax. Just notice how that feels. We always hold our stretches when we're doing static stretching for at least 3 deep breaths or 20 seconds, and that's going to help us to gain flexibility. Any less than that, and you're waking up the joints and helping your circulation, but not much else. And now we'll bring that back knee to the floor and the hands down to the inside of the front foot. If this is uncomfortable for you, you can always bring the hands or the elbows to the front thigh. You can adjust yourself so that you're comfortable here. You might want to move that front foot further out to the corner of the mat to give your knee or your hip more space. And then from here, we're going to bring the right hand to the right knee. So the hand on the front knee side, shoulders down and back. Inhale and extend the spine first. And then we'll exhale, look up toward the sky and allow your shoulders to follow. Now, if you'd like, you can reach that right arm up toward the sky. If you'd like to intensify, wrap the arm back behind the body and allow your shoulder to follow. You can also curl the back toe under and lift the back knee up off the floor for the deepest stretch. Breathe, make sure your bottom arm feels strong here, and always just return to the modification of your choice, whatever you need to do to feel safe and comfortable in this pose. Now let's inhale, reach up toward the sky. Exhale, hands down to the inside of the front foot, back knee comes down to the floor, and we'll shift to the back knee. Lift the front toes up off the floor, turn the foot to the side, and shift forward. Good, yes, and now we're bringing that stretch into the adductors again. So we should feel that between the knee and the hip on the inside. You can shift from side to side here if you'd like, very slowly and mindfully. And we're relaxing that front leg and foot as much as we're able. Good, if you'd like, you can walk the hands forward and bend the elbows in toward the body to deepen your stretch. Here, we're prioritizing our front knee. Make sure that it feels safe. You can shorten the distance between your front heel and your back knee if you'd like to give a little more space to those joints as well. Good. Yep, breathe into it. Relax your shoulders, relax your jaw. And now we'll bring the hands under the shoulders and press up. Shift onto the back knee, recenter the front foot, and we'll step forward into forward fold. Relax down over the legs. Let the body hang. Shift into the heels and lift your tailbone toward the sky. And here's where we're really going to notice if our blood pressure is negatively affecting us today. So if you feel dizzy or nauseated, you're going to want to raise the head above the heart line and then just keep that information in mind as we move through the rest of our class. And now we'll step the right leg back, top of the back foot and back knee come to the floor, and we'll bring our elbows to the front thigh. You might know now, or maybe you already know, which side is tighter. That's just usually going to be the same side every time. And we're not looking to force things to be exactly the same one side of the body to the other. We're just looking to balance the load as much as we can, so no pressure there. Tuck the tailbone. Really bring that stretch into the hip flexor and quadricep. Notice where you're tensing and you don't need to be. So relax the shoulders. Lengthen the spine. Good. Breathe. Yeah, really good. And keep smiling. Yeah. Good. Now you can curl that back toe under and lift the back knee up off the floor if you'd like. Good. Excellent. You can shift around. You can shift further into that back heel if you want to stretch out the calf and Achilles tendon. You can tuck your tailbone a little bit more. You can lift the chest a little bit more. Breathing deeply always. Good. One more deep breath in. Exhale the back knee down to the floor and we'll bring the hands down to the inside of the front foot. Again, you can move that front foot out to the side a little further to give some more space to those joints. And we're just settling into our position first. So we never want to stop moving or start moving before we've had a few breaths to just figure out where we are today. And then from here, we'll bring that hand on the front knee side to the knee. Shoulders down the back, deep breath in, extend the spine. Exhale, look out toward the sky and allow your shoulders to follow. So I want you to settle into this pose for a minute and notice where you're feeling it. Feel that bottom arm nice and strong. Feel your hips relaxing into the stretch. And when you're ready, if you'd like, you can reach the left arm up toward the sky. You can wrap that arm back behind the body if you want to. You can curl the back toe under and lift the back knee up off the floor if you like. It's always a modification of your choice. And of course, you can always come into a child's pose or just bring both hands down to the floor for a low lunge anytime. Breathe. Relax wherever you're able. Now let's inhale and reach up toward the sky. Exhale the hands down to the inside of the front foot. We'll bring that back knee back down to the floor. shifting to the back knee before we turn to keep our knee safe. So just be aware of that. And if you'd like, you can shift from side to side, slowly and gently. And as you move your weight around, just noticing how your stretch changes and focuses in different areas. And if you'd like to deepen the stretch, you can walk your hips forward. You can bend the elbows in through the body if you want to. Again, as you inhale, keep widening the back. As you exhale, relax wherever you're able. If you're bending the elbows, make sure they remain equidistant from the floor. So we don't want to be getting one closer than the other. Good. And now bring the hands back under the shoulders, shift to the back knee, recenter the front foot, and step forward into forward fold. Relax down, let the weight of your body stretch out the legs. Bring some nice fresh oxygen to the brain. And then we'll bend the knees and roll up slowly, one quarter at a time. Roll the shoulders down and back. Reach the arms out to the sides and overhead. We'll baby back bend on top. And we'll release down through prayer. And release the arms. Excellent. So now we're standing. We're going to find the soles of our feet at the back of our mat. So rocking back and forth across the balls of the feet and the heels here. And settling in the center nice and even on all four corners of the feet. And we want our tailbone tucked or strong. I'd like you to roll the shoulders up, back, and down. Place in your palms might open to the front a little bit with that shoulder placement. Arms are relaxed at the sides. Neck is long and the chin is tucked. Good. Let's inhale the arms up to the sides and overhead. Focus your gaze on anything that's not moving and come up onto the toes. So that dristi, that physical gaze that we're looking at something that's helping us to stabilize is also the mental, spiritual gaze where we're focusing our attention to still the mind and be here in the moment. So we're noticing our breathing, we're noticing how the body feels, where our balance is today. And let's take one more deep breath in. Exhale down onto the heels and we'll fold forward, relaxing down over the legs. Great, now let's just gently bend the knees and we'll slowly roll up one more breath at a time. Roll the shoulders down the back, reach the arms out to the sides and overhead. Focus your gaze and come up onto the toes. So your eyes can be on anything at all that's not moving, preferably 6 feet away from you or less, but it doesn't have to be. Now we're just going to do a little balance exercise. I'd like you to shift to the left foot and raise the right toes, and then shift to the right foot and raise the left toes. Keep that gaze focused. Try and keep the heels lifted up off the floor. And we're just observing where our balance is today. This is going to be easier for you if you come to a hard surface, if it's too hard on the mat. Good. Just one more time on each side. Moving as slowly as you're able. Really good. Yes, good. Last one right here. And inhale, reach up toward the sky. Lift up as high as you can. Exhale, down onto the heels, and we'll fold forward. Relaxing down on the legs. Give it a break. Breathe. Excellent. Now we'll bend the knees, slowly rolling up one vertebrae at a time. Shoulders down and back. Arms come up to the sides and overhead. And release down through prayer. And release the arms. Excellent, yes. So little practices like that daily help our bodies and help our brains to be more stable and balanced all the time. So I encourage you to try that just for kicks. So now we're going to come to all four corners of the feet once again for some single leg balance asanas. So finding front and back nice and even, inside and outside, and we're feeling nice and loose through the lower joints, but everything is engaged. We're standing tall and open. And shifting from left leg, let's come into a tree pose, bringing that right foot into position, wherever is comfortable for you. So you might only want to do single leg balance with no twist, and that's fine. Otherwise, you can come with me and turn the knee up to the side, and bring that foot to the calf, the thigh, or the top of the thigh, or anywhere else is comfortable for you. One or both hands can come into prayer, so if you need to hold on to that foot, that's fine, as long as you're not allowing your chest to cave in around that leg. Good, yes. And remember to focus your gaze on anything that's not moving, 6 feet away from you or less. Suck the belly button toward the spine because our balance comes from our core, not the soles of our feet. Good, shoulders down. And when you're ready, if you'd like, you can reach those arms up above. Part the hands and drop the shoulders. So we're channeling all of those beautiful trees out there now. You know, that flexibility, that balance, that being in the world in any weather, and being flexible. Good, relax your shoulders down. Good. Now let's inhale, hands together. Exhale down through prayer. Release the leg and we're shifting to the right leg, left foot comes into position, might be a different position from the other side, and that's fine too. Okay. And then one or both hands come into prayer. And just like our flexibility, our strength, and our endurance, our balance will change from one side of the body to the other. So we're just working with it. Okay. Press that left knee up to the side. Tuck your tailbone. Lace up the core. Feel the sole of your supporting foot. Feel the strength in your supporting leg. When you're ready, you can reach the arms up above. And then part the hands and drop the shoulders. Good. Yep. Relax your shoulders down. Breathe. Now let's inhale, hands together. Exhale, down through prayer. Release the leg. And work out the ankles. Great job. Well done. Okay, so today we're going to try an eagle pose. There's lots of variations. You can also choose to do only upper body or only lower body. So we're going to come into a crossover, both upper and lower body at the same time. I'd like you to reach the arms out and cross the right arm over the left, okay? You're going to tuck the elbows in or as close as you can get. You might be up here on the wrists. Then we're going to bend the elbows. If this is where you are, that's fine. Or you can place palm to the back of the hand. Or you can twist and place the backs of the hands together in front of your face. Or you can come and twist all the way around, wrapping with the palms together. So you want to keep your wrists straight and feel the stretch between the shoulder blades. Now we're going to bring in the lower body. Okay. So shifting to the left leg, sink down, bend the knee, push into the heel. We're going to cross the right leg over. So you might be here, single leg balance. Or you might cross over and put the toe on the floor for balance. Or you might wrap all the way around and place those toes on the opposite side of the calf. It's all up to you. This is an advanced pose once you get here. So if you'd like, if you're all the way here, sink down to the hips. Push your elbows down toward the floor and breathe. One more deep breath in. Exhale, I'm going to stand up. Step wide, toes point forward. Good. Deep breath in, reach up. Exhale, fold forward. So that's a good hip opening release. We want a nice wide release after a lock position like that. Other side arms, left over right, bend the elbows. And it's always wherever is comfortable for you. Just make sure that you're not compromising your wrist in order to get here. So we just want to be nice and straight, aligned wherever we can. Press the elbows down and feel the stretch begin up between the shoulder blades. Our core is strong. And now we're going to shift to the right leg. Bend the knee. That left foot comes in, toe can stay on the floor here. You can cross over to the other side, or you can wrap all the way around and sink down into the hips. Good, suck your belly button in, press your shoulders down. This is a lock position, it's an energizing position. We're breathing into it and always coming to the modification of your choice. You can reduce intensity anytime. One more deep breath in. Exhale and release, step the feet wide. Good. Stand tall. Deep breath in. Exhale. Tip forward. Excellent. Relax down. Bend the knees. Roll up one vertebrae at a time. Shoulders down. Arms out to the sides and overhead. Exhale. Release. Work the heels and toes together. Step the feet together. And that's all. That's the toughest it's going to get today. Excellent job, guys. Really well done. Okay. My goodness. We're almost out of time. So we're going to make our way back down to the floor. Come into the back of our mat, walking back and forth to find the four corners of our feet and finding our full height here and feeling nice and open in the world. And we'll inhale, arms out to the sides and overhead. Exhale, fold forward, relax down. Now you can come with me and walk the hands out into downward dog. If your neck and shoulders are not comfortable, you can remain in forward fold and then just come down onto the knees when we do. Good, relax here for a moment. Breath in. Exhale, knees to floor, sit back, child's pose. And again, arm placement is up to you. You can also shift from side to side if your hips need a little bit more of a stretch all around. We're relaxing wherever we're able. Great. Now let's press up. We'll turn around and sit down on the mat. Roll down onto the mat and bring the knees into the chest. Rolling the knees around in a circle, one way and the other. And I want you to feel the body begin to relax down into the floor. Just let your head and shoulders rest. There's no tension in the upper body at all. Great, and I think we'll finish off with a knee down twist. So leaving the legs where they are, reach the arms out to the sides in a T-shape to the body. Take a deep breath in. Exhale, drop the knees to the right side, looking out shoulders should be on the floor now, and the knees can hover. You can place a fist or a cushion or anything else underneath the knees to support them in the meantime. Now we're checking in especially with our lower back, making sure that feels safe. And we'd like the stretch to come to the middle and upper back. Breathing, lengthening through those fingertips. Good. One more deep breath in. Exhale the knees back to neutral. We'll hug the knees into the chest and the forehead toward the knees. Great. Release the upper body down. Leave the legs where they are. Arms come out to the sides and we'll come along to the other side. Deep breath in. Exhale, drop the knees to the left side of the out over the right fingertips. So throughout this movement, again, we're sucking the belly button toward the spine to keep the core engaged so that we can control the depth of our stretch and the speed of our stretch. So we just want to be easing into it. We never relax fully into the stretch until we feel safe doing so. We should always put that mind fully with deep breathing. Lengthen toward those side walls. Feel the arms get longer. Good. One more deep breath in. Exhale the knees back to neutral. Hug the knees into the chest and the forehead toward the knees. Let's finish with our full body stretch. Breathe in deep. Reach out for the fingertips and toes. Extending toward those walls. Lengthen. Exhale, bring everything in, knees to chest, forehead toward the knees. And again, breathe in deep, reach out, expand, take up lots of space. Exhale, bring everything in, squeeze all the air out of the body. One more time, breathe in deep, reach out, lengthen, and smile, you made it. Exhale, bring it in, curve it around. Great, and then let's release the body to the floor for our final relaxation. I'll ask you to find socks or blankets or whatever you need to be warm, because we will cool down now that we're no longer moving. And the purpose of our shavasana, as always, is to quiet the mind. And once you quiet the mind, we can choose our pattern of thought. So if you'd like to come into gratitude exercises, and there's lots of research that shows how these feelings of joy and gratitude and awe are very good for ourselves, very good for our bodies, rejuvenating and healing and all of these other great things. So we'll start with just to focus on the breathing, and I'll walk you through a very basic guided full body relaxation. Let's take a deep breath in all the way down to the tips of the toes, closing the eyes, and exhaling completely, feeling the body relax down into the mat, to the earth. And now for one more moment, bringing your attention to today's class and giving yourself that mental pat on the back for making it here, for making it through, and especially for maintaining the lines of communication with the body. That's so important. Our bodies tell us so much. Now we begin to relax from the bottom up. Breathe in all the way down to the tips of the toes, balls of the feet, the arches, heels, and ankles, stirring up any tension that might still be left there. And exhale it out, pressing it out of the body with focus. Breathe through the calves, the shins, the knee joints, and thighs. Exhale tension all the way down to the bones. Breathe through the hips, pelvis, buttocks, and lower spine. Exhale, tension. Feel the body relax down into the floor, into the earth. Breathe through the muscles of the lower back, side body, and abdomen. As you exhale, feel the internal organs and the circulation slow down, relaxing. Breathe through the middle and upper back, through the rib cage and solar plexus. As you exhale, feel the heart and lungs slow down. Breathe through the collarbone, shoulders, biceps, and elbows. Exhale, tension. Allow the arms to relax at the sides. Breathe through the forearms, wrists, palms, and backs of the hands. As you exhale, let the fingertips let go of tension. Relax the muscles of the neck, through the top of the spine and the base of the skull. Relax the throat. Relax the jaw. Relax the muscles of the face, around the eyes, mouth, and ears. breathing naturally as you sink deeper into relaxation. Breath in, exhale, and open.